You are amazing. I mean, look at you. Trillions and trillions of cells, and they all know where to go and what to do. That is amazing. How do you do that? You don't know? Well, I don't either. We just often tend to forget how amazing life is because we are oblivious to the tiny things happening inside of us. For instance, have you wondered how much DNA you contain? If you were to take all the DNA molecules from your body and stick them end to end, how far do you think you could reach? A few centimeters? Meters? To the moon? Well, it turns out that the DNA in your body would add up to 10 billion kilometers stretching from Earth to Pluto and back. Well, that's a lot of DNA. How do you keep all this stuff organized? Because I don't know about you, but if I just try to keep my earphone cords organized in my pocket, right, this is what I end up with. So now, let's imagine you're one of your own body cells. How do you organize your DNA? Fortunately, you as a cell have evolved a specialized container, the cell nucleus, to store your DNA. And if the nucleus was the size of this ball, you as a cell would have to fit 200 kilometers of DNA into this ball without getting it all tangled up like last year's Christmas decoration, or in this case, my climbing gear. Because you as a cell, ultimately, you want to divide. And how you do that is you grab your DNA from left and right, and then you start pulling, but you immediately see the problem. If your DNA is tangled up like this, you fail to divide, or you break your DNA. And broken DNA is very bad because it's a common cause for cancer and many other diseases. Now, I'm a biophysicist, so I like to study living systems through the looking glass of physics. And physicists have proposed that DNA is organized into thousands of loops rather than just being randomly coiled up. Unfortunately, however, no one has seen these loops because the cell nucleus is just too tiny and too dense for our light microscopes. For that reason, I took single molecules of DNA and I clamped them onto a glass surface, which allowed me to observe them under a light microscope. And when I exposed these DNA molecules to the liquid inside the cell, something interesting happened. I could observe ring-shaped protein complexes, think of them as tiny motors, grabbing the DNA and making a loop, which prevents the DNA from getting all messed up. Now, finally, we begin to find these DNA loops in all organisms, from tiny microbes to you amazing humans. We all keep our DNA in the loop.